Let us discuss about grouping of resistances. In your previous classes also, you might have studied about grouping. And for the same, we can write, in general, a resistance grouping, or which is called resistance combinations, can be divided in two major categories. These are, the first one as series combination and the second one as parallel combination. Even after study of both of these combinations, we'll see later that there are some combinations which can neither be kept in group 1 or group 2. These are called mixed mode combinations that we'll discuss later. Right now, about resistance grouping or combination of resistances, we are going to study about calculation of equivalent resistance, for which we can write, if we talk about equivalent resistance for a resistance grouping, we can write that for a given group of resistances, if all resistances are replaced by a single resistance in which we can write all the electrical properties which we are going to discuss now, regarding the group remains same, then this single resistance can be written as, or this can be regarded as, equivalent resistance of that group of resistances. We'll discuss several situations in which we'll see how this grouping takes place. Let's first discuss about the numerical calculation for the equivalent resistance for a given group on the next sheet. In this diagram, you can see if there is a group of resistances which is connected across a battery of EMF E. Now, in this situation, if a current I flows through the battery due to the group of resistances, and if the whole group of resistances is replaced by a single resistance, we define as equivalent resistance for this group. Then also for the same EMF battery, the current flowing through the circuit must remain same. This will happen if the single resistance will act just the same as that of this group of resistances. And here we can write the current flowing in the circuit will be E by R equivalent, because if E is the EMF of this battery, then in case of an ideal battery, the potential difference across the resistance will be equal to E, and the current flowing through the equivalent resistance can be given by Ohm's law directly as E by R equivalent. So in this situation, if there is a group of resistances through which a current I flows, then the equivalent resistance for this group of resistances can be defined as E by I, that is the ratio of battery EMF applied across the group of resistances divided by the current flowing through the battery. So you just keep this in mind that for any group or for any resistance combination, equivalent resistance can be given as, this equivalent resistance can be given as potential difference applied across the combination divided by current flowing through the combination of resistances. This is the way how we can directly calculate the equivalent resistance for any group of resistances. Based on the same logic, we are going to analyze the series and parallel combination and their equivalent resistances in coming sections.